Back on the shtick for the last show of the year. We've got a show about politics, schmolitics, because we're about to have some elections in the state, federal, and one of the people I've been trying to get on the show in the studio is right here with me, Martin Foley MP.
Thanks. Very fun.
That's all right. You're a very warm kind of personality that I really admire in politics.
You're too kind.
It's true. I don't know what it is about your personality, but you seem to be everywhere I look, you're there.
Well, we trip over one another wherever we go, that's for sure, Henry. There's no show without Henry. If you're not there, I wonder why I'm there.
Exactly, because it's really important to be on the spot. And you've got an amazing abundance of portfolios that I just can't understand how you can even, you know, I'm not going to even go through them with you. But you can tell me about them.
Oh, well, I've got four portfolios. Yeah. Housing, disability and ageing is one. Mental health is another. And they have a kind of coming together around trying to change how government delivers services around the needs of people with different vulnerabilities, trying to focus on the vulnerabilities rather than the silo of government. The other is the creative industries, where we have a lot to do with each other at multiple events in the arts, in the film, in community. And the other is a new portfolio called Equality, which is trying to focus on the rights of LGBTI communities. And of course, the Jewish LGBTI community has been at the front leading the way in reform in so many of these areas. So in just about all of those areas, Henry, run into you somewhere.
And the last one you haven't mentioned, you forgot about, because mental health.
Yeah, I did mention mental health at the start there.
But did you? Yeah, you put that into the bundle.
I put that into the bundle. And yeah. If anything, the mental health portfolio is one of the most challenging because one in two of us over the course of our life will have a severe mental illness, and one in five of us at any time during the past 12 months will have had a mental health challenge. And how we deal particularly with treatment at both the acute end and the community end, whilst challenging the stigma and discrimination that still goes with so much of how we talk about mental health, that's a real challenge for our whole community.
Mm. So there seems to be a synergy. It all comes under one heading, Martin Foley's portfolios. Really, you've got that. And you managed to juggle all that?
Well, yes, I've got lots of good help, but the Andrews government is very serious about reform, about getting on and achieving a lot in all of those areas, because there's so much to do. Our growing community, our growing population, its different needs, its different demands requires an active, strong, interventionist government. And in all these portfolios, that's what I think we've tried to achieve.
Because one of the issues you've just recently approached or made a move in is homelessness, which you've just thrown $206 million to.
Yes, the latest announcement was how we're going to deliver 1,000 new public housing units, which will cost $206 million in six locations around the state. But that's on top of, already over the last 4 years, an additional $1 billion that we've spent in homelessness and housing support, everything from rough sleeping, family violence, targeted programs for youth, for mental health sufferers, for Indigenous communities, all the way through to partnering with social and community housing providers to build more roofs so more people have a secure roof, but equally the services they need to keep in secure housing. And as we know, the cost of housing and private rental is such that there's increasing demand as people get pushed down that economic pipeline into housing crisis, and so many tipped into homelessness, increasing numbers tipped into homelessness.
The other thing you've just announced is the bike path on St Kilda Road.
Yep.
That was only today.
Yes, so we see some 3,000 bike riders a day go up St Kilda Road. We see hundreds of thousands of users of St Kilda Road, mostly now public transport, particularly with the Melbourne Metro station underway. So the community of bike riders and others have been calling for this for some time, and we've announced a substantial package, $26 million to deliver that outcome should we be re-elected over the next couple of years, to align from the St Kilda Town Hall, Copenhagen dedicated paths to the junction, and then dedicated paths up the either side of the tram line all the way to the city.
Mm. And the other thing we have to mention is the ageing issue at the moment, the aged care. There is a commission, Royal Commission, going on with that?
We welcome the Royal Commission into our aged care, particularly our aged care residential services. It's a it's an issue that we all are going to have to confront. And what we've got to wonder is, has the regulation and the standards of what since 2013 has been federally regulated, is it adequate? And I think the evidence of so much lived experience is that it isn't. The Victorian government is the only state that still provides residential aged care services itself. And as a result, I'd like to think our nurse client ratios that we have, just like the nurse patient ratios, of over 5,000 beds, gives us a higher level of service and standards than some of the very distressing examples that we've seen that have led to the Royal Commission. Having said all that, standards, how things are funded, and how people are cared for, how, particularly as we age in our community and when we tip over into residential care, how can we make sure that that's funded and of the highest quality, because they're all someone's parents, they're all someone's friends, they're all someone's loved ones, and you know, some of the stories have been pretty bad.
There are so many other issues I'd love to cover with you, including public transport, because we are having a real problem with road traffic.
Yep. A city of 5 million people that we are now, we can't keep growing out beyond the margins of the city growth limits forever. We've got to become a global city based on world's best public transport. Metro 1 that is underway, Metro 2 that's being planned, the suburban rail loop that the Andrews Labor government is committed to, they're all very important for heavy rail, but equally so is tram transport, bus transport, and trying to change the way in which we organise our cities so we have active transport and active engagement in work, in homes and in schools locally, so we encourage more bike transport, more active walking, more commuting locally rather than this linear city that, you know, dormitory suburbs, work in the city or somewhere else. The nature of how we construct an international city of 5 million people is really going to be built and achieved on what we do with public transport.
The last thing I want to mention is, because I've just been to Sydney and I got off the plane, got on a train, I was at Bondi Junction in 15 minutes or less. Yeah. Why haven't we got it? This is incorporated in the new plan, isn't it?
Yeah. So a train to the airport's been coming since as long as Tullamarine's been there. Now at least we've
I'm laughing. I'm sorry. I have to laugh.
We've now at least got a dedicated funding plan incorporated within the suburban rail loop proposal that State Labor has put out there. So I think...
The question is, what year will it be made? Is this how long term is it?
Jacinda Allen, the Public Transport Minister, is committed to a process and a timetable, and I'd like to think that within a 10-year frame that we will have that built and delivered, given that a large slab of it is underground from the city to Sunshine, linked in from Sunshine to the rail loop to the airport.
Well, I wish the state government a lot of luck, and it's been fantastic to have you on board. And we're looking forward to the election, which is all about winning.
Well, it's all about what sort of future we want for our state and our communities, and whether we want to keep backing a government that's showed it's got a record of getting things done. Having said that, having achieved a lot, it just goes to point to how much more there is still to do.
Certainly is. Thank you so much, Martin Foley, MP.
Thanks, Andy.
We'll be back after the break with Serena Grasso, who is the candidate in the state elections for Caulfield, running against David Southwick.